everyone. In this video, we'll be breaking down the main components and parts of your fluid pump. Now, why do you need to know what your pump consists of? Well, why do you need to know anything? I firmly believe that you should have a basic understanding of the equipment that helps you run your lives. So it should be mentioned that not all pumps are going to look like these. It really depends on the type of pump and the application. So right here we have a Zoller sewage pump, and here we have an Armstrong three-piece circulator. So pumps are really consisting of two main parts, and that's the volute and the motor. So we're going to start with the former. So the volute is what houses the water that's being pumped in through the impeller, which actually slows down the flow rate and increases the fluid pressure. Inside the volute and connected to the motor shaft is the impeller. An impeller is a rotor used to increase both the pressure and flow of a fluid. There are four components to an impeller: the eye, where the fluid enters, the vanes, which push the fluid, the channels, which are the spaces in between the vanes where the fluid flows, and the bore, in which the motor shaft attaches. There are many different types of impellers, but they all come down to either single or double suction and are either open, semi-open, or closed. Now, changing the impeller type will change the application parameters. Next is the diffuser, which increases the flow while decreasing the flow velocity, which in turn increases the flow pressure. Now, the volute will also have a discharge outlet or port that allows water to be ejected from the pump. And don't forget about the suction inlet or port, which allows the water to flow into the volute. Now let's take a look at how these components work together. The shaft, powered by the motor, connects to and spins the impeller, which creates a suction, bringing water into the volute through the suction inlet and ejecting it out through the discharge outlet. Next up is the motor or drive that converts the electrical energy into mechanical energy. Now, the motor is the workhorse of the pump. The motor either comes in fan-cooled, TEFC, or oil-cooled, ODP. The average motor consists of quite a few main components, so we'll have to go through them slow one by one. Here at the core of the motor, we have the rotor, which is the moving part that turns the shaft. Here we have the stator, or the stationary part of the motor's electromagnetic surface, the air gap, or distance between the rotor and the stator, the windings, which are the wires that are laid in coils, usually wrapped around a laminated soft iron magnetic core, so as to form magnetic poles when energized with current. We have the commutator, which consists of slip ring segments used to switch the input of most DC machines and certain AC machines. Now, attached to the rotor is a spline shaft, which attaches at the other end to the impeller. This shaft delivers the mechanical power transferred from the motor to the volute. Covering the motor shaft is the shaft sleeve or bearing. The sleeve supports the applied load while allowing the motion of the shaft and reducing friction. So how do these components work together? The power source supplies the electricity, which is transferred to the motor by the power cable. The stator consists of the windings and lamentations, or thin metal sheets, and form the electromagnetic poles. The commutator alternates these poles, which interacts with the rotor, making it turn. The shaft connects to the rotor on one end, turning the impeller attached to the other end. So we almost have a complete pump, but we're missing one of the most important parts, the mechanical seal. Now, the mechanical seal reduces leakage between the rotating shaft and the stationary pump casing by maintaining contact at the sealing interface and sliding on each other. Now, this allows the shaft to pass through a sealed case. This is a mechanical seal, which is the most common type of seal. Other seal types, like packing seals, are for the most part outdated and less efficient. The seal must contain four functional components. First, the primary sealing surfaces, like silicon carbide, ceramic, or tungsten carbide, are embedded into the pump casing, and carbon in the rotating assembly. Other materials can be used depending on the application. These two surfaces are in close contact. One ring rotates with the shaft, and the other is stationary. Next, the secondary sealing surfaces, like O-rings, wedges, or diaphragms, which create a barrier but are not rotating relative to one another. You also need a means of actuation, which in this case would be a spring. Finally, a means of drive, in this case, the motor. The seal sits inside of the cover plate. The stationary surface presses against the cover plate and has the other surface rotating with the motor shaft, which slides inside of the entire seal. This creates a watertight seal that prevents water from leaking through to the motor. Keep in mind that anytime you take the volute apart, it is important that you change the mechanical seal. Now, you now know what an average pump consists of and a general understanding of how it works, because you never know when that information will come in handy.